Hello, my name is Eric, and I'm going to tell you something about my Hewlett-Packard calculator collection. The reason that I collect Hewlett-Packard calculators is because I love the way they work with reverse Polish notation. I got hooked, I got interested in Hewlett-Packard calculators, and I decided to start collecting them. The first pocket calculator ever created was the HP 35. It came in an optional sturdy carrying case together with its pouch, the adapter, and here it is. So this is actually the second model. The first model is very rare and it has an extra dot behind the on. After that came this version, and as you can see, there is no actual number on the calculator. It doesn't say HP 35, it just says Hewlett-Packard here. Of this version, this is the early one. It has a raised dot on the 5, and soon afterwards it became more popular than they thought, and they started creating more versions. So here are two later iterations of the same calculator. And as you can see here, it says Hewlett-Packard 35, and here as well. And the difference here is that they changed these top keys. So instead of putting the functions above the key, they started creating the functions on the key. So three versions of the HP 35 calculator. It was introduced early 1972, and it was ultimately discontinued back in 1975. In 1973, after the success of the HP 35, Hewlett-Packard created what is now called as the Classic series. It was the HP 45, 46, the HP 80 and the HP 81. I unfortunately of that classic series only have the HP 45. But in 1975 they introduced the Woodstock series, not named after the musical festival but after the Peanuts character, by the way, which included the HP 21 and the HP 25. So as you can see here, I have these in packaging with manual. So here is the HP 21, and similarly, let me show you the HP 25. So very similar calculators.
Yeah, there's an orange button.
Yeah, there's an extra shift. So we can clearly see it has more functions. So the blue and orange shift functions. The blue labels are below it, and the yellow shift function are above the keys. And this one only has one shift. It was a somewhat cheaper calculator. 1976 brought more innovations for Hewlett-Packard. And it brought this HP 67 calculator, which had a magnetic strip, magnetic card reader in it, so you could read the cards that you programmed your software with, and then you could label the labels here A, B, C, D, E, so that you could read what the functions were. And also, I have this HP 97. This is a printing desktop calculator. ...1977 brought printing pocket calculators for Hewlett-Packard. So you have this rather basic function HP 10. And this rather advanced and a bit rare HP 19C. So printing pocket calculators. And maybe it's a good moment to talk a bit about serial numbers. Not sure if it shows on the camera, the serial number. As you can see, this serial number starts with 1909S. The first two digits are actually the year it was produced, minus 1960. So this one was produced 1979. In week number 9, and the S stands for Singapore. I'm going to show you an earlier example calculator. Here I have one of the early models, HP 35s. So 1975, third week, also S in Singapore. And here the very early HP 35, it says 1230A, and the A stands for America. It was created in Corvallis in Oregon. So 12, 1972, the 30th week. In 1978, the Hewlett-Packard introduced a very nice series called internally the SPICE series. And it was the 31E, 32E, etc. And the E stood for engineering. So I will show you some of these calculators. The 31E. The 32E. There's a 33E. Down here. And the 38E. In 1979, Hewlett-Packard introduced the last series with LED display. And it was a continuation of the earlier 30 series, which ended on E. These were the same calculators, but called 33C, 34C, etc. And here you have two examples. These were exactly the same calculators, and the C stood for continuous memory. That was the only difference. So here the 33E and the 33C side by side. And the only difference was continuous memory, which meant that if you changed your batteries, the program that you put in is kept in the 33C, while it was not the case in the 33E. And that concludes the LED era, the era where LED displays ruled the calculators, drained our batteries, and in 1979 a nice invention was done in LCD, liquid crystal display, as we all know it, which was much more nice for the battery consumption, and Hewlett-Packard started creating LCD display calculators from 1979 onwards. In the next episode, I'm going to show you the early LCD calculators by Hewlett-Packard, including of course the HP 41, later on the 28 and the 48, up to the Palm Tops.